Hello, viewers, and welcome back to Duskers. I am super annoyed. I just lost a recording. The recording did not close properly on account of my computer running completely out of hard drive space because Payday 2 felt the need to update, and I only had 17 gigs free. And you know, it's got a 100 meg update to download, so of course it's going to expand and fill all of my available hard drive space. Anyway, I did this space station here, Hamasien. It was incredibly frustrating. Literally, I would say 90% of the rooms came back with inconclusive results from the motion scan, and it was a real pain in the ass to get around. Fortunately, it was also probably pretty tedious to watch, so, hey, lucky you guys. You get to skip that. So I was thinking about the Thackeray. I might take the Thackeray over, depending on what its upgrade slots look like, because it has 85 scrap capacity. And that's compelling to me. Not that I've ever actually had more than 50 scrap, but, this thing's gonna break down at some point. I mean, we may as well hijack every reasonable ship we come across, right? Well, let's head over there and see. You know, I was pretty happy with my commentary on that episode, though. I don't know why Payday 2 updates the way that it does. It doesn't make any sense. I get that they, I get that they have all of their resource files packed up. But why does it unpack the files, do diffs on stuff, and then download the actual files that are different? Why doesn't it just do diffs on the packages and download the packages that are different? I know they broke their packages down into smaller sizes recently. It should be a perfectly feasible way to force the update that wouldn't require so much hard drive thrashing on the end user. Okay, that's what I like to see. A green. God damn it. That's not what I like to see. Okay, we are gathering the fuel and we are getting the hell out of here. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Okay. And we're leaving. Just no interest at all in dealing with that. Yeah, absolutely there was more ship. For sure. I hear you. Listen, I hear what you're saying. I hear your complaints. Hey, wasn't there a bunch more ship there? Yes. Yes, there was. I am not interested. Hate, 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 hate that devil fungus garbage. This is worth upgrade, or this is worth repairing. I know we didn't find any extra scrap on that ship because of it, but it does find extra scrap pretty frequently. So let's have a look at this sector. Government, medical, private. Nothing very compelling. Let's refresh ourselves on our objectives right quick. We're looking for dock ID 1185. Still haven't found it. Medical vessels might have, because he's a doctor and everything, medical vessels might have some value on that. We are looking for observation and research outpost communications. Still haven't found a way to get onto an outpost. The only situation in which we've been able to find a transporter was when we could not find a ship that had an available upgrade slot. There needs to be a way to scrap stuff out of your upgrade slots. You should be able to, at the very least, just break the shit and haul it out of the wall, right? Have one of the drones just pull on it till it comes loose. Search military outposts. Scan all rooms on a Class A or B space station. I've actually not done that. I forgot about that one. Okay, that's interesting. Oh, man. I've been saying devil fungus. What if that stuff is the gray goo? What if it is a The reason it expands so quickly is not because it's growing organically. It's because its molecular assemblers rapidly assembling more of themselves in your direction to reach out to you. Yeah, oh, I bet that's what it is. That makes it not any less gross. I suddenly found this, and I don't remember. I think that may have been last episode, which is lost to time. But the objective's light never seemed to be blinking, but I found another one of those Hey You communications. There have been more protests, fundamentalists saying that we're breaching our trust in God, that we should let everything take the course He set for us. It's like the world's religious zealots have put aside their differences to efficiently annoy me. I wish you could tell them otherwise. We've had a couple of bricks thrown at us, a fairly nice potted plant, and even a screeching cat. That last one was a lie, but these people are amazingly creative when it comes to being utter asses. Honestly, it's getting pretty frightening. I think they're actually having the National Guard come down next week, as this is getting out of hand. Unfortunately, that text could apply to almost any of these potential threats, except for the Super Predator, I guess. And then, yeah, we also found this, which appears to be about the molecular assemblers, the food replicators. But not really a lot of new information here. Just people trying to live their lives. Alright, I think we're jumping over to this sector. Because we don't have a lot of other places to go. Okay, well here we are at the space station. What did that say? Brogdon? Brogdon. Fantastic. Okay. Nothing of interest. Yeah, that stuff might be replicator goo. Why do you have to start with this one? Jeff is just being difficult. I guess I scanned the room already. I don't need to walk my sensors all the way over there. Okay. This does not look like a very large station. I guess it's Class C, so I already knew that going in. Oh, look at that. I actually get to, you know, enter rooms. Isn't that fun? The bit of the wall looks strange to you. Okay, propulsion fuel. I don't even care if the results of the motion sensor scan come through saying that there's no enemies. I just want them to say, you know, not yellow. Okay. Let's D11 and leaving. I'll move us around to this other airlock real quick and run the motion sensor again, and if it comes through clear, we'll check out room 5. Yeah, I'm not risking it. We searched most of that station. Didn't find as much scrap as I was hoping for. Alright, so Medical A, Infestation Types 3. Well, a high class, I want to say. Is A a high class? I don't know. But a medical vessel is more likely to have docking records from our good doctor than other types, I suppose. How much scrap do we have? 10? Okay, I'm still not going to repair the sensor module. One 1185. That's the right one. Find an access vessel gun mall to obtain final algorithm from Dr. J. Holmes. Alright, now we know what we're looking for. Look at that, we're making progress, probably. We're making some kind of progress, a thing that could reasonably be described as progress. And the fuel access point is in the first room. And there was nothing in it. I know that that one piece is back there. I'm coming back for it. I just want to do this real quick. Okay. All right. That is some exciting news. So, gun mall. Kind of an awkward spot here, buddy. Alright, it's fortunate that these drones are pretty resistant to collision damage. Okay, no clean readings at all. If this room gives me a clean reading, I can at least use it to check room 3. So one thing I can do is I can try to approach from one of the other airlocks, maybe get some data that will allow me to deduce some things about the safety of other rooms. So yeah, we'll just move the ship around a little bit. Run the motion sensor through the door. Nope. Okay, so this room, and this room are all inconclusive. Actually, this room is too, just so that I can't possibly use it to gather information. So, what is my plan? I can't use the sensor module to figure anything out, because the only place that I could put it, the only room I can go into that I know is safe, is this room. And I can't just drop the sensor module. So I guess what we're doing is this, then. We're just spacing rooms, and then... Yeah, I totally forgot to. I don't feel great about that, because we lose whatever loot might be in them. But, like, we have to... We have to try to find a foothold. Nope, R6 also is unsafe. Jesus Christ. What is the value of these motion sensors exactly? How do these things work that they're able to come back with inconclusive results so frequently? Okay, an empty ship upgrade slot. Okay, so every room on the ship, except for the one we started in, is unscannable. So how am I supposed to make any headway here? I guess I could space a couple more rooms. Right, I can do this. There has to be a room somewhere that my motion sensor can get some kind of reading on. Has to be. Okay. About damn time. So what is in this room? A lot of doors. But running the motion sensor here doesn't make a lot of sense because they can't even access any of these rooms. But the fact that we now have a room that actually scans does let me do some testing at least. So let's start with this one. Blanking on the commands. Okay, so I can't squeeze through this room safely anymore because it's going to close behind me. And we didn't find another power inlet. So I can't leave the drone on the generator and I can't get any exploration by going anywhere else. So I guess we're just done. Oh, this stuff is so frustrating. Yeah, if I'd found another power inlet, we could try running the ship from the other side. Man, you remember how excited I was way back in the early episodes when we found that remote power system and it was, like, totally cool? I would be so much more excited to find one now. Think about it. Being able to power a ship without having to have a drone sit on a... Oh, we got a thing. Oh, right, we knew about that. Yeah, we got that. So we're looking for the vessel Gunmall. I mean, what are the odds that we're going to find any particular vessel out here in the vastness of space? I had to think somewhere around the ass end of zero, right? I'm trying to figure this out. None of these are, like, particularly compelling. This one's actually kind of interesting as a potential commandeer. So I could go medical A. Actually, we could go the Lee with 4 fuel, leaving us with 3. No, actually, that's not safe. Okay, we're gonna go to the King's Domain, and then we're gonna jump to the Turquoise Blue and try to take it over. It only has one infestation type. It's stable. It has a much higher scrap capacity than our ship. I don't know how long it's gonna be until we start seeing equipment failure on board our ship, but I do know that it's going to be soon. Ooh, more stuff. I am surrounded by brilliant computers and equipment, computers that can process information at unimaginable speeds. Yet, not one of them can help me get to a solution without those damn samples. The feeling of futility is overwhelming. And I pray that someone out there can get the data to me soon. Powerlessness is driving me mad, and I can tell Emma is as scared as I. She just sits there quietly as I work, staring at the stars. Okay, so this is an entry from Dr. Holmes. Well, that is not useful information. And also, we already know what we're looking for in that regard, so... Okay. So while he's doing that in the most asinine way possible, let's think about our options for searching. God damn it. We've got to find a way to deal with this stuff. So, like, what am I... what are my possibilities for dealing with that stuff? We know that the sonic weapons are pretty effective. They at least are unpleasant. Twiki, what are you doing? Keep working. I just wanted to turn Twiki around so that we could see the direction the stuff's gonna come from. We have a little bit of time. I just really want to try to find a way. Wait. I don't want to do this. Well, the stuff's still not coming through the wall yet. Let's lock that door. I don't know how long we have, but it's not coming through yet. Okay, hold on. Let's not be hasty here. I'm getting nervous about the stuff, but it's turning out that we have literally no options for exploration that don't involve dealing with a ton of this garbage, so... Now, let's give this room a moment. We'll see if it clears out. Well, looks like it might be safe. You know, it is worth noting, actually, that Jeff might be relatively safe as far as exploration goes. He can't really get his path back to the ship cut off, I think, because I'm pretty sure that he could just teleport back to room one. That's some weird audio interference in this room. Is the door still clear? Okay. I don't really want him sitting that close to the wall, on second thought. Okay, so... all of the rooms out of room 4 came through with yellow scan results. Alright, let's see if we can redock at airlock 2 and get a clean scan result, because we could clear that room out real fast. And that would make me feel a lot better about bailing out of here quickly if the whatever it is starts spreading. Wait, don't do that. Do this. Okay, good. Yes, clean result. Tim, go check for spreading gross goo stuff. Okay. You guys have to not all be as close as possible, as close as dronally possible to the door. Out of curiosity, what do you have? Ooh, mines. That's actually really good. Scan for garbage, and we will not find any. All right, you need to get back in here. Jeff needs to go get that piece of scrap. didn't find anything. Okay. Alright, I feel pretty good now. Even if we get flushed out of here, we hit the fuel line already. We got that drone that we found, which is a good amount of scrap. What's that? Okay, hold on a second. I think we should just leave. The ship just made a noise like it's about to break apart, which is almost always followed immediately by pipes breaking and radiation leaks. And we only have 3 minutes until an asteroid, which, you know, obviously can wreak some pretty significant havoc. We should just get out of here. We found 4 scrap, a new drone body, and an actually pretty great upgrade, in my opinion, so I think we're going to take advantage of that. Yeah, let's do this. So, now that we're here, we can go back and hit the Ruby Tiger if we find at least one unit of fuel. Oh, this is what I wanted. Let's get that mine module out of you and put it into someone. Maybe Zach is a mine layer. In which case, I think, actually, he probably also gets the lure. Okay. We're finding uses for things. So, one infestation type. It's a Class B vessel, so it's probably going to be kind of large. Oh, you know what else we should do, actually, is, this. I'm really tearing through those at probably higher than our replacement rate. Okay. Let's hope that we can get this thing clear. Hope that it doesn't have any of that damn devil fungus. Ooh, wow. Okay, well. Obviously that has to go if we're going to get a commandeer off here. And the fact that we saw motion, while we know we only have one infestation type, gives me hope that the ship doesn't have any of that stuff on it. Whatever we're fighting is a good old-fashioned, solid, moving, biological, probably controllable threat. Gives me immense solace in these uncertain times. Okay, so that sucks. But a clean scan on room 3 means that we can at least use it for science. Just kind of doing a little drone ballet here. Waiting patiently. Alright, well. I feel fairly confident about that. Let's check this one. I have to say, I don't know exactly why that fungus stuff freaks me out so much. It's probably because I'm thinking of it as fungus and, like, how would you possibly deal with a creeping mass like that? But, you know, it's actually scarier If it is, self-replicating, nanomachine type gray goo, because there's even less you could do about that. It's going to be way more resistant to fire, which is, like, the only thing I can think of that would be helpful against the fungus. Alright, look at that. So this is the full extent of this ship, huh? I think we have a commandeer on our hands here. Wait. It is kind of making some weird noises. Okay, not my favorite thing. But that is all the rooms. Let's get out of here real quick. And commandeer. Oh, it has zero upgrade slots, though. No, we can't take it. We need a transporter. We'll just continue on with our Justice Rider for now, I guess. It does tell me pretty conclusively, though, that we cleared the ship out all the way. That's nice. We have certain goals, and we need our ship to have certain characteristics for us to accomplish those goals. Okay, well, we gotta repair that. Yeah, we did. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and run this ship in this video, because it's a C class, should be pretty short, and we can then wrap this system up. I can't imagine. Yeah, can't imagine we would find out anything particularly interesting there. Alright, so, yeah, another very small ship. Okay. Terrible, terrible reads. Okay. This was pretty quick. Nothing of interest here. And we'll let it wander back over. Well, that was pretty simple. Wait a second. Wait just a damn second. Yeah, the fuel access point had to be in this room. Okay, no jump cells. That's a shame. Now it. Hey, look, we scanned the entire ship. Alright, well, that's going to be it for this episode of Duskers. We found some, you know, we found some valuable information. I'm glad that that's not in the episode we lost. Gun Mall. Well, let's have a look at the other galaxies real quick. I don't think that I've seen that ship, because I would like to think I'd remember the name. you. Was there a Stargate that I just didn't see, or... am I getting out of here? Oh yeah, this system. Yes, totally has a Stargate. Well, it's not actually going to let me... actually, are we going to run out of jump fuel here? That's kind of not great. Okay, that was weird. It wouldn't let me, you can see it had the ship drawn right here, and it wouldn't let me move around. Alright, well, let's jump through the Stargate. We don't really have a lot of options here. Wait. They both show known systems for visited for. Hold on a second. Where am I right now? I'm in Digimall. Damn it. So, yeah, this display is not helpful. Okay, we are in a position where we need to... oh my god. We're in a position where we need to find some damn jump fuel. Military clearance required. Oh, so to get into military outposts, you probably have to... hijack a military vessel. That's interesting. Well, since this is the only thing to do in this system, let's bang this out. Transporter? Transporter? No. Sonic weaponry, though. You know? Oh, a transporter would be on this screen. I'm gonna sell it to reserve fuel from our tank. Okay, no, the Sonic Pulse explicitly says that it repels organic threats, and it does repel that stuff, so it must be some kind of fungus. It's just a fungus that grows very quickly when it feels like it. Well, the Sonic weaponry is not actually a very good answer, but it only costs 3 scrap to buy it, and we would get 3 scrap by scrapping it. So, may as well. Okay, what about this system? This system is really not better. Man, if we don't find a transporter, we're just not gonna be able to play the game anymore. Yeah. Jesus. Alright, well, come back next time. When we maybe run out of fuel and just drift forever through space. We'll see you then.